हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर डिस्कसिंग द चैप्टर फुटप्रिंट्स विदाउट फीट एंड अप टू नाउ वी हैव कंप्लीटेड दैट ग्रिफिन हैव स्लिप्ड इनटू अ बिग स्टोर रूम एंड आफ्टर इट बीइंग क्लोज्ड ही रैप्ड हिमसेल्फ विद वार्म क्लोथ्स ऑल्सो कंज्यूम्ड मीट एंड कोल्ड कॉफी एंड देन स्लेप्ट ऑन द हीप ऑफ क्विल्ट एंड Now today in this video we will continue the story and let's see what happens next. So let's read. If only Griffin had managed to wake up in good time, all might have been well. As it was, he did not wake up until the assistants were already arriving next morning. When he saw a couple of them approaching, he panicked and began to run. They naturally gave chase. In the end, he was able to escape only by quickly taking off his newly found clothes. So once more, he found himself invisible but naked in the chill January air. Okay, dear students. Griffin was sleeping in the big store. And he also put on warm clothes. But it would have been very good for him if he could wake up before the arrival of guards, or in other words, before the opening of that big store. But he could not do so. He wake up very late, and by that time, the guards of that big storeroom already were approaching towards him. And when Griffin noticed those guards coming towards him, he became frightened, and in panic he began to run. And that's why the guards who were guarding at that big store, they thought something wrong, and naturally they ran after Griffin. And in this way, once more Griffin was in a great problem, and that's why again, for being escaped from those guards who were chasing him, he quickly put his clothes, his newly found clothes, off. And again he became clothless, or we can say naked. And in this way, after being naked, he became invisible and was escaped from those guards. But the problem was that once again he was naked in the chill air of January, or in the chill weather of January. That's why again he was clothless, homeless, and even moneyless. So again problem was the same with Griffin. This time he decided to try the stock of theatrical company in the hope of finding not only clothes but also something that would hide the empty space above his shoulders. Shivering with cold, he hurried to the Drury Lane. He entered the theater world. Okay. This time he did not try to find his clothes or food items from the big store or any such place. This time he decided to enter into the theatrical world. And he was thinking that in theater world he would get not only clothes but also something to eat and some place to live in. So in this hope for getting some clothes, getting some place to live in, getting some food to eat, he entered in the Drury Lane, which was connected to the theater world. He soon found a suitable shop. He made his way invisible upstairs and came out a little later, wearing bandage around his forehead, dark glasses, false nose, big bushy side whiskers, and a large hat. To escape without being seen, he callously attacked the shopkeeper from behind, after which he robbed him of all the money he could find. And when he entered the theater world, he found a suitable shop. In that shop, as he was invisible, so in that same condition, being invisible, he entered the shop, went upstairs in that shop, and a little later, he came out while wearing bandage around his forehead, dark glasses, false nose, and wizzy big whiskers. And apart from these things, he also put on a large hat on his head. It means once again he found clothes and he suitably fitted himself with these new clothes. Bandage around his forehead, glasses, dark glasses, false nose, big bushy side whiskers, moustaches, and large hat. And again he wanted to escape from being caught or being punished. That's why this time he thought that he will not put off his clothes. Instead of doing so, he thought some other plan. What is that plan? He callously, without feeling any pity towards that shopkeeper, Griffin attacked that shopkeeper from behind. And after that, Griffin robbed that shopkeeper with all his money, as he could found in that shop. So in this way, Griffin took several things from that shop, like bandage, dark glasses, false nose, big busy side whiskers, large hat, and he also robbed that shopkeeper with his money. And once again, he wanted to escape from that place without being punished. So what he did, eagerly to get away from crowded London, he took a train to the village of Epping, where he booked two rooms at the local inn. So he wanted to escape himself from that crowded place of London. He quickly caught a train and reached the village Epping, and there he booked two rooms to stay in a local inn. And the arrival of strange at an inn in winter was in any case an unusual event. As strangers of such uncommon appearance set all tongue wagging, Mrs. Hall, the landlord's wife, made every effort to be friendly, but Griffin had no desire to talk and told her, "My reason for coming to the Epping is a desire for solitude. I do not wish to be disturbed in my work. Besides, an accident has affected my nose." So when Griffin reached the village Epping and booked two rooms in a local inn, so this event, particularly during the winter, was not general. It was an unusual thing that a person coming from any city, coming from London to a village and stays at village in winter season. This was not a usual thing. And particularly with the person who was very strange, he was looking very strange, uncommon. And that's why all the people from the village Epping, they started talking about Griffin. They started putting questions about Griffin. and Mrs. Hall. Mrs. Hall, the wife of landlord, the wife of the inn in which Griffin was living on rent. So Mrs. Hall tried her every way to be friendly with Griffin, to make friendship with Griffin, but all the time Griffin showed no sign to be friendly with Mrs. Hall. And in return, whenever Mrs. Hall tried to be friendly with Griffin, in return Griffin behaved her badly and also told her that the reason for his coming in that village Epping is only the search for solitude, peace, and that's why he did not want to get disturbed by anyone. And he further adds that an accident has affected his nose. So in this way, Griffin did not try to be friendly with Mrs. Hall, while Mrs. Hall was regularly trying to be friendly with his tenant, Mr. Griffin. Then, satisfied that her guest was an eccentric scientist, and in view of the fact that he had paid her in advance, Mrs. Hall was prepared to excuse his strange habits and irritable temper. The fact was that Griffin had already paid the rent for the two rooms in which he was living. That's why Mrs. Hall compromised with the irritable habits of Griffin, and she thought that the eccentric scientist who was living in her rooms was eccentric, and that's why he excused, he neglected his strange behavior, strange habits, or irritable temper, as he had paid the rent in advance. But the stolen money did not last long, and presently Griffin had to admit that he had no more ready cash. He pretended, however, that he was expecting a check to arrive at any moment. But the present scenario was that Griffin was out of money, as the money which was looted from the shopkeeper was spent, and at present Griffin had no money. But at that time he pretended that soon he would get a check, and that check can arrive any moment. So dear students, in this way story continues, and today in this class only this much. In next class we will continue the story and we'll know what happens to Griffin next. Thank you for watching this video.